The 41st Hawaii International Film Festival's opening film is showing tonight. It's the world premiere of Waterman, and it's taking place at the Bishop Museum.
It's about the life and legacy of Duke Kahanamoku, a film that's been years in the making. Kamakapili is at the premiere and joins us now with more.
In 1912, Duke Kahanamoku made it to his first Olympic Games. That year, breaking world records, he came home with not just a gold, but with a silver as well. All these years later, his legacy continues and his relevancy remains. Tonight here at Bishop Museum, a film entitled Waterman is making its world premiere, sharing the life of Duke. Let's track down the director because I personally want to find out more.
On white, sunny beach of Hawaii.
He's a very busy man, so we were able to sneak him away just for a couple minutes, the director of Waterman, Isaac Halasima. Thank you very much. I appreciate this, and congratulations for getting here. You know, leading up to this point, watching the trailer to this is very inspirational. As a Hawaiian, makes you very proud. How did this even come about? How did this opportunity land in your lap?
Yeah, well, it starts with my uncle. Most people know of the statue of Duke Kahanamoku on the beach, and my uncle, Jan Fisher, made that statue, and that connection. He had a very keen eye on my career. One is his Polynesian nephew growing up, you know, but I was also growing up as an artist, and he's the one that told me, you know, I should try to give this a shot. And then when he died in 2016 is when it really started hitting me that I need to kind of take him up on that. And I started chasing it down and then found the producers that helped me out with this. They're a nonprofit, and it was at Sidewinder Films, gotta throw it out there, but because I just love that they believed in me, you know, that's why. But started pushing this story from there. And it in the end, this is about 5 years though in the making.
Well, through that 5 years, and I can only imagine the research and the effort and the things that you come across to put this together. I think one thing when we speak of Duke, we always hear the positive. We hear his achievements, but we don't necessarily hear the challenges and discrimination, for example. Through your research, what are some stories that you can speak of, knowing now that this is something that Duke actually had to go through?
Yeah, well, I've always thought it was interesting that, you know, it seems counter to what we do nowadays, you know, and that's what it was. He would, like an example would be, you know, dealing with the first time any of them really saw segregation with the Outrigger Club and those things that, where it was just the way the world did it. So Outrigger did what the world did. I'm not tearing on them at all, but he decided to go, oh, we'll do, that's okay. You guys do your thing. We're going to do our thing. And he creates Huinalu with his brothers. And then next, you know, it becomes, we'll add women. We'll add all these parts. We're going to make it super fun. And of course the other clubs get jealous because this is fun, you know? And that was his answer, was positivity. When someone was mean to him, when someone was treating himself, he didn't treat a whole people like that one person. He saw the person, and then he believed in them, and that they would do something right. And I feel like that's what we need nowadays, is something like that, to be able to try to do the good thing.
For the public and for viewers, it's limited opportunity to see this. Tonight's all sold out, and I believe there's maybe one more screening. But from this point moving forward out of this festival, I mean, is there going to be an opportunity that this is available to the public?
Yeah, well, we're still bouncing around to other festivals. Like, I'm flying from here to Florida, and I'm excited about that one, because I love it. But we are going to do some openings, like a wide open public thing, as soon as we're done with the festival circuit. And believe me, Hawaii, this is for you. That's why. So it's going to be out for everybody out here.
The film Waterman only has one screening here on Oahu, but for neighbor islands, there's three more screenings in the weeks ahead. This is all part of the Hawaii International Film Festival, which kicked off yesterday, lasts all the way through the 28th of this month. For all the information on all the films being shown, make sure you head to our website, khon2.com. Kamakapili with KHON2 News, working for Hawaii.